Here's another thing that unites the best writers. They're not afraid to write. The default BBC script is safe. Truth is, sometimes that slips over into being a bit boring. Whilst you must always be factually accurate, editorially sound, and properly appropriate, you can be adventurous. It's always best to keep your sentences short and simple, but if the pictures will carry them, slip in a simile, go mad, use a metaphor. Let the poet in you blossom. Love whatever language you're broadcasting in. Don't be afraid to try a line that just comes in and lightly kisses the pictures brighter.
The burning air yields nothing. Too many seasons without rain have turned the ground to dust. Like so much of the rest of the Horn of Africa, the lands of the Turkana are in the grip of drought. They are nomadic pastoralists who depend on the rain to provide grazing for their animals. Now they come seeking relief.
Of course, when it comes to writing for pictures, don't forget the basics. If you're just describing what the viewer is seeing, the chances are you're getting it wrong. The words want to complement the pictures and enhance them, not just mimic them. And of course, all the other basic rules of packaging apply. Be clear about what it is you want to say and structure your story. But if you think you've got a good line, try it out on the team. The look on their faces will generally tell you if it's a good one. And who knows, they may even come up with a suggestion that makes it better.
Like a rocket on the launch pad. The Phoenix escape capsule. And strapped in like an astronaut, the very first rescuer, poised to plunge half a mile under a mountain.
Even on a dank grey day, the deep gold stonework of Durham Cathedral exudes a warmth which matched the affection of those who flocked to celebrate the life of Sir Bobby Robson. Contemporaries, successors as England manager and former players all united in their esteem for a remarkable man. Inside, his family found themselves surrounded by many of the best-known figures in the game, hearing about his personal compassion and passion for football.
And here's another thing that a lot of the good people I work with do. They mutter to themselves as they write. They speak the sentences as they come off the keyboard. It's not enough that the words look pleasing on the screen. They have to sound right too. It's about the rise and fall, the rhythm and flow of the script. And of course, when you come to lay down the track, the delivery has to be right. There's no point in having a script that works beautifully with the pictures if you then deliver it in a deadly monotone.
As a producer who's had nearly 100 heart attacks caused by late feeds from far-flung places, I can't believe I'm going to say what I'm about to say. But when you've finished, go back and polish. Don't be silly about it when you're hard up against the clock, but where you can, go back, watch the whole thing through, and where you can, make it better. This is something that the best I've worked with do again and again. It's as if only watching the whole thing through that they realise what needs changing. Sometimes it's just a word or two that need polishing brighter. Sometimes it's a phrase that needs honing to a sharper point. I suppose the point is for them it's about making it as good as it can be. Not just when it's the lead, but every single time.